When was the last time that you were actually sick with amazement? No, when was the last time you were actually white with sheer terror? These things deliver authentic emotion, authentic data. And the bum bit of history is that it depotentiates human individuals. Just in order to live inside a historical society, you have to sculpt yourself down and down and down. You mustn't be in other people's face. Everything is confined. This is the attitude of history. It's what's called being part of the public. It's something necessary for democracies to do business. There has to be a public. But when we identify with the public, we essentially become creatures of the herd. And there is no peace until the end. There is no let-up in pressure until the end. As we approach the transcendental object at the end of time, history moves faster and faster. We have been approaching this transcendental object since before there was a we to speak of in human terms. In other words, this is the same attractor that pulled life out of the oceans, caused primates to stand on their hind legs, and so forth and so on. But obviously, pick a number, about 20,000 years ago, 10,000 years ago, the process quickened. We turned the corner. Everything began to move faster. And again, at the fall of Rome, faster, faster. And again, in the 20th century, faster, faster, faster. Well, nobody has drawn the obvious conclusion from this. If we're going faster and faster, faster and faster, then hell, we're gonna get somewhere pretty soon. And that's where I think we are. We can hardly go any faster without the speed of our acceleration passing into the domains of humanly cognizable time. In other words, the reason things are getting weirder and weirder is because the space-time continuum itself is accelerating. It's entirely possible that the last half of the life of the universe will happen in about 3% of the total life of the universe. Nobody said that it has to take as long going down as it took to come up. It may be that the coming up took a long, long time, and the going down can be catastrophic, sudden, unexpected, dynamic, we say. And that's why I take and I return to this theme, because, hey, I return to all things, that history is an anticipation. History is the last call that the train is leaving the station. You know, and the call echoes back to Çatalhöyük and slightly beyond. But in our own lifetime, it's now palpable. You know, all you have to do is close your eyes in a quiet place. Think, and you will behold the transcendental object at the end of time. You can feel it informing your own life. I mean, you spend a good deal of time denying it because rationalists tell you you're either losing your mind or it's impossible and it can't be happening. But this sense of plottedness, of connectedness, this sense that we are all in a universal drama playing to a close, this sense that we are larger than ourselves, that we are somehow characters on a stage, this is a phenomenon of the light at eventide. This is a phenomenon of the final moments of the cosmic drama. And I think it's tremendously exciting. I think this is what nature set about 700 million years ago on this planet. That it's not about chipmunk after chipmunk after chipmunk for eon after eon after eon. I mean, a little of that goes a long ways. I'm sure you'll agree with me. That's all very fine, but the way nature works is she builds upon her complexity. We can feel that we're more than animal. We have this dimension, which we call spiritual, which, and some of us buy into some off-the-shelf explanation, Catholicism, Mormonism, Jainism, something like that. Others of us wrestle with it, or we smorgasbord it into, you know, a little Kabbalah, a little Taoism, a little Tantra, a little Hasidism, it doesn't matter, you know, do that. But whatever it is, we wrestle with this part of ourselves which cannot be simply dismissed as monkey meat. And I think that it is the soul, that the soul is actually an entity in history seeking to be born, and that the enterprise of history is the creation of the collectivity as an eternal, indestructible, trans-dimensional object of some sort, the tool at the end of time.